it was a rough time to be in Contian. We were always on guard. When we was on downtime, we were still ready for an attack or something. They would come in and just say, okay, you've been promoted to corporal. You've been promoted to sergeant. So it was a promotion, but it was because we just lost three guys and there's only five of us left, you know, so someone's got to be it. The day before we was on the patrol, got there and came back. And of course, there was a hill. There's always a hill in Vietnam, believe me, there's always a hill. And that next day, which was Thanksgiving Day, we thought we was going to have the day off because they were shipping in by helicopter them big square things with our Thanksgiving dinner. Going to have some turkey and mashed potatoes. And this lieutenant wanted to go out for a patrol. I said, great. And our squad got chosen to go with him. And we went on the patrol. And he wanted to go down on the other side of this hill. And I said, sir, we've been there yesterday. We don't need to go down there. Let's just go back and have our Thanksgiving dinner. There's nothing there. But I knew the trail looked different. Because when we was there the day before, it was, you could see like any trail, you know, dirt trail, and all the brush was on the side. This had too much junk on it, you know, land on it. So he said, no, I want to go down there. So I stopped everything and I took myself and one other guy. We walked down a ways. When I was going on that, down the trail, I was kind of looking at the side brushes, figuring that they had something tied to the weeds or something. I wasn't looking too much on the ground. Well, then a breeze came by with my, you know, you're walking, and I seen this real thin wire, okay? And you're walking, and you see it. Your brain works, eyes work faster than your brain or whatever. Well, it's true, because I seen it. My brain knew it, but I couldn't tell my foot to stop. But it looked like it was in slow motion. And then, of course, when you hit the trip wire, I, you know, kind of flew up and stuff. But that was always, I'll never forget that, because it was just like you see on TV sometimes when you're supposed to see it. You know, they show you the trip wire and the guy's foot. But yeah, but I seen it. My brain knew it was there. But I just couldn't stop that foot from going far enough to hit it. Well, the right foot was pretty well pulverized. The left leg had a lot of shrapnel in it and stuff. And on the USS Repose, they did a lot of surgeries. And I had my left foot. Okay, and I lost my right foot about calf high. And then as things happened, I ended up losing my left foot because the blood wasn't getting to it and all that kind of stuff. So I had both knees at that time. Well, I was on the USS Repose, and I was kind of like in a coma. You know, you're not in a coma, but they got you drugged. You just, you don't wake up, you don't drink, you don't, you know. But every once in a while, your eyes would, you know, do one of them. And all of a sudden, I started yelling for the nurse because I heard something. And, of course, I yelled corpsman, not nurse. But he came running and because I hadn't said anything in a day and a half or 2 days. I said, I smell something. Well, he smelled it too, and it was gas gangrene. Rank, nasty, you know, yuck. You know, kind of like vomit with a phosphorus odor, something like that. It was nasty. Yeah, I won't forget that smell. I won't forget the smell of blood where someone, you know, like when you're on patrol and suddenly they've had a battle and there's a lot of blood on the ground, it starts drying. I'll never forget that smell either.
Mike Ferguson eventually recovered from his injuries and later worked with other Vietnam veterans to spearhead the construction of the Illinois Vietnam Veterans Memorial in Springfield, Illinois. He currently lives with his wife Gina in Apache Junction, Arizona, where he continues to be involved in veterans organizations.